मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट दिस इन द फर्स्ट न्यूट्रिशन इंट्रोडक्शन। सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिफाइन द डाइजेशन। व्हाट इज डाइजेशन? ब्रेकिंग ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स फूड मॉलिक्यूल्स इंटू सिंपल वन, इंटू सिंपलर वन बाय हेल्प ऑफ एंजाइम्स digestive juices. So digestion, how do you define it? Digestion, breaking of complex food molecules into simpler one by the help of enzymes and digestive juices is called as digestion. Okay, so you take the complex food, rice or some curry or some noodles, you are taking some complex food that are broken down into a smaller one, and the nutrients are absorbed, carbohydrates, proteins are absorbed from that food. That process is called as digestion. Now coming to the human digestive system. Human digestive system. So the human digestive system is called as alimentary canal. Human digestive system is called as alimentary canal, or you can simply call as gut. Okay, so several parts are present in this alimentary canal. So it starts, it's a long tube. Alimentary canal is a long tube which contains several parts. So it starts with the mouth. Alimentary canal starts with the mouth. And ends with anus. In between the mouth and anus, there are several parts. So let us look how the digestion takes place in each and every part. First, let us see how the food passes. First, I will tell you the pathway first. Mouth. Mouth is also called as oral cavity or buccal cavity. So from the mouth, you can also write mouth or buccal cavity. Okay, so food is entering into the body through mouth or buccal cavity. Afterwards, the food passes into the esophagus. It is also called as food pipe. Now from esophagus, the food enters into the stomach. Okay? Now from stomach, it enters into the small intestine. Or you can say it enters into the duodenum. Duodenum is the first part of the small intestine. Next, from here it enters into the, you can write here, first part of small intestine. Okay, duodenum is the first part of the small intestine. From duodenum, it enters into the second part. Actually the second part is called as jejunum, but you don't have that name, so you can write small intestine. This is the second part of small intestine. It is called as jejunum, but you don't have vacuum, so just from duodenum it enters into the small intestine. From small intestine it passes through large intestine. Okay? From small intestine it passes to large intestine. From large intestine to rectum. And rectum to anus. It is sent out through anus. So food, the passage of food is starts from the mouth, which is also called as buccal cavity. From buccal cavity, the food enters into esophagus or food pipe. Then it enters into the stomach. Then stomach, from stomach it enters into duodenum, which is the first part of the small intestine. Then it enters into the small intestine. Here the digestion is almost done. Digestion is completed in the small intestine, and then it is absorbed. The food is, the nutrients are absorbed into the walls of the small intestine. Whatever the remaining undigested food is passed into the large intestine. Okay, clear? In the small intestine, the digestion is completed and absorption starts. Absorption of nutrients takes place in the small intestine. Whatever the undigested food is remained, that is passed into the large intestine. In the large intestine, only water is absorbed and the whatever remaining is sent into the rectum. From rectum, the undigested food is sent out through anus in the form of fecus. So, fecus is nothing but motion. You pass on the motion daily. That in science words, you have to say it as fecus, not motion. So, the undigested food is sent out through anus in the form of fecus. Okay, this is the pathway of human digestive system. Now, let's see the diagram. So, it's a rough diagram. So, this is our mouth. It starts with esophagus. Mouth enters into esophagus. Esophagus opens into a stomach. Stomach opens into a duodenum. Duodenum opens into a small intestine. This opens into large intestine. So this is the diagram, rough diagram of human digestive system. So this is our mouth. Okay, here you have salivary glands. We will discuss them. So this is our esophagus or food pipe. Next, this is our stomach. Next, this is our duodenum. This is our large intestine. Now this is our small intestine. Okay? This is our rectum. And this is our anus. Now here you have some glands. Some glands are also involved in the digestion. So we will discuss that also. So this is here, pancreas is present. So here, pancreas is present. Okay, now here liver is present. this is the rough diagram of human digestive system. So it starts with mouth. Mouth enters, mouth opens into esophagus. Esophagus opens into stomach. Stomach opens into duodenum. Duodenum continues as, duodenum is the first part of the small intestine. It continues into the second part of small intestine. So here the complete digestion of food occurs and absorption into blood. Absorption of nutrients into blood starts. So after that, the undigested food from the small intestine, the undigested food, whatever the digestion has not occurred, the undigested food moves into the large intestine. And it comes to the rectum and comes outside through anus. This is the process how the digestion is taking place in the human body. Now let us discuss each and every part in detail. Now first, mouth. So if you see the mouth, what happens in the mouth? The first digestion takes place in the mouth. So to take the food through your mouth. So we take the food through our mouth. In mouth, what happens? We have teeth. We have tongue. In mouth, we have teeth and we have tongue. So what they do? The teeth helps in crunching. Teeth helps in crunching of food.